Good morning, student. Today we are going to study about the different types of organizations. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the organizations, its characteristics, then about the process of organization. Process of organization, I told you, you have to remember the points of the process of organization in order. But in characteristics, that is okay, you can write point up down, but in the process you have to remember the point in order. Organization, which is a structure of two or more than two peoples working together for some common objectives. In organization, it is very important that delegation of authorities and responsibilities is assigned to the persons who are working with you in the different ways. Employees and the employer, or you can say managers or the owners, they all have different objectives. Combination of these two objectives, employees' objectives and owners' objectives, is coordinated through the organization. So organization is one of the important function in the post-COP planning. Post-COP, that is given by George Terry. Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordinating, reporting and budgeting. As per the Luther Gulick, this post-COP is most important for as a function of business organization, in which we have already studied about the planning and we are studying about the organization. That is the second part of the post-COP given by Luther Gulick. Now let's start about the types of organization. Types of business organization. There are five types of organization. First is formal, second is informal, third linear, fourth matrix, and fifth functional. These are the five types of organization. In exams, they can ask you a questions, write five types of organization. Then you can write them. First is formal, informal, linear, matrix, and functional. Formal and informal, these are the three important ones, linear, matrix, and functional. These three organizations are under the formal organization. So I am drawing the diagrams accordingly. These three are under formal organizations. But informal organization is the shadow, of formal organization. Shadow of formal organization. ORG. You can say that is a short form of the organizations. So here again, formal organization ka shadow kaun hai? Informal organization is a shadow of formal organization. But in formal organizations, we have linear, matrix, and functional. So linear, matrix, and functional are under the formal organizations. So before studying linear, matrix, and functional, now let's start first with the formal organization and informal organization. Today we will study about the formal and informal. Let's start with formal organizations. Here, formal organization, that is the first organization in the types of organizations. Formal. To achieve objectives, formal structure is created among the persons and the work. Different persons are working together in the business, and among them employer establishes the relation, and that relation which is established due to work, that work relation is considered as the formal organization structure. It is created among the persons who are working together in the business, and that structure is called formal organization structure. Now, characteristics of formal organization. Different characteristics of formal organizations. And it is formal organization is most important organization of the business. There are certain characteristics of this. First is formal structure. Administrator. Administrator means those persons who administer or manage different activities of the business. Administrator form the formal structure. This can be asked in MCQ. Who forms the formal structure? Then you have to write administrator are the one who forms the formal structure. They are the most important person to form a structure in the business. So administrator are the one who form the formal structure. Then second one is lacking flexibility. Place of work or position is not changeable. Once the formal structure is created, remember this, once the formal structure is created and work is assigned to you and position is assigned to you, it won't be changeable. You can change your transfer or promote the person as per his ability, but once the work or position is decided, it cannot be changeable. That's why it has lack of flexibility in formal structure. Third one is delegation of power. Top level assign power to the middle level and middle level assign powers to the bottom level. This we have already studied in the first chapter. Top level assign powers to the middle level and middle level assign powers to the bottom level. Why they assign powers? Because they assign powers because they have already given them the responsibility to do certain work. So delegation of power is one of the most important thing in the formal organization. Then fourth one is large size. Structure of many people, so large size. In formal organization is a structure of many people who are working together in the business. Many people means more than 10 people are working in an organization and in the different departments. Suppose there are 5 departments and 10 people are working. So structure is of large size, that means of 50 people. In some of the organization, the structure may be of 1000 people, 500 people. That's why they have written the size of the organization is of large. Fifth one, particular relation. Relation among employees is work related. Relation is work related as per the relation of work. That's why it is a particular relations. You are related with the persons along as per the work. That's why it is work related relation is in this formal structure. Then communication. Communication is done through formal ways. Formal ways may be letters, emails, note, notice, etc. Communication is done in such a way that it has proof. That's why the communication is done in the formal way. Every time the communication is done in the formal way means it has some proof which can be proved that the communication is being done in the past. After the formal organization, let's study about the second one, that is informal organization. Relationship formed automatically without any conscious objectives, without any conscious effort, without any conscious objective. When a relationship is established, it is called formal organization. Formal organization ka shadow hai. That is, informal organization is a shadow of formal organization. This I said you before also. Dash is a shadow of formal structure. So here you have to write in dash. Kya likhne ka? Informal organization is a shadow of formal structure. Now let's see the characteristics of informal organization. Informal organization formed due to human working together. When many people are working together, there are chances that they become friends, and they, due to their friendship or due to their interest which are same, the formal informal structure is created among the human, and that structure is called the informal structure of the organization. Second one is based on human relations. Informal structure is based on human relations. Having same feelings, same interests, same hobbies, or having the same kind of working, or having the same areas of working, then there are chances that relationship are developed among the persons, and that relation is human relations. That's why it is considered in the informal structure. Then third one is ever changing. Informal structure is goes on changing. One group may join another group. Here, informal structure, sometimes it is seen that one group may join another group. What do you mean by this? Suppose three friends are working together in some organization, but due to the misunderstanding, miscommunication, fight or quarrel happened between them. So one of them may join the another group. But this structure is informal. It will not affect the business activity, or it will not affect the goals of business activity. So here we can say informal structure is ever changing. It goes on changing from time to time. Suppose one person leave the job and he joined the another job, then the group which is formed in the first job may be end. That's why it is ever changing mode. Then fourth one is universal. Found everywhere where people are working together, anywhere, whether it is India or any country of the world, for informal structure is found everywhere. When you are working somewhere, the persons who are working with you, you become the friend of that particular group, and you become the member of that particular group. You meet them even after the working hours. That means it is found everywhere in the world. That's why informal structure is a universal structure which is found everywhere in the world where people are working together. Small size. Mostly the size is small, depend upon the individuals. Size is generally small. While we have seen in formal organization, size of the organization is big because all the employees are included in that. But here size is small because only few individuals are involved in this. Lack of control. No control is maintained over the workers who are working together. Lack of control means you cannot control the relations among the workers which is formed due to they are working together. A manager or administrator cannot control them. You have no control over the workers for their informal structures. Seventh one, informal communication. Communication is done in the informal way. Informal way means it does not have any proof. Any kind of language is used, even the harsh languages, even the naughty languages are used for the communication purpose. Now, students, you have to remember this in informal structure. Sometimes if manager wants to convey some important message and he don't want to convey this through the formal structure, but he can convey that message to the employees through informal structure. And informal structure is very helpful to convey some message without any source. Even managers use this informal structure to convey some message and to make their work accomplished. Informal structure is generally created among the group who are working together, that is friends. But manager use this informal structure for his own benefits. So while you are working somewhere, you have to remember that how your relation is with the persons who are working with you, what kind of relation you have, and what managers is seeing in your relations. So students, today we have studied two types of organization. One is formal and second is informal. I am briefing you with that formal structure, which is a compulsory structure, and other three like linear, matrix and functional comes under the formal structure, while the informal structure is a structure which has its own way, but it is considered as the shadow of formal structure. Okay, so today we have studied about the types of organization two. In the next class, we will learn about the different types of organization. Means we can study about the three types of organization in the next class. Thank you.